Hi, I'm Erika, one of the senior curriculum managers here at Magoosh and a GMAT expert. Now, I've said it before and I'll say it again, what makes a GMAT math question higher difficulty or at a higher level is the question's complexity, not its subject matter. So that means that a question on any topic can be 400 level or 700 level. Check out my video on the hardest and easiest GMAT math questions for more on this and a breakdown of some example problems that have the same question topic, but wildly different difficulties. Now, that said, what makes a question higher difficulty or a higher level isn't necessarily what makes it hard for test takers. There are certain concepts that most test takers really struggle with, regardless of the level of the question. Now, this is really bad for their scores because they're missing easy questions on that topic, because for them, those easy questions are actually really hard. In this video, we're going to break down six of the hardest GMAT math concepts that you're likely to encounter on test day. Now, stay tuned for the end because the last one is likely to surprise you. So the first hardest GMAT math concept is combinatorics, and this is actually kind of a two-in-one because combinatorics encompasses both permutations and combinations. And therein lies the challenge, because not only do we have to memorize two different formulas, two different approaches, but we also have to be able to identify within a problem which one we have. So is this a permutation with the permutations formula with a permutations approach, or is this combinations with a combination formula and a combinations approach? Now, that's challenging in and of itself, but there is also more challenge because there are kind of fancy things that we can do with combinatorics that make them more challenging. So we can bring in restrictions, we can bring in things like at least problems that can take something that's already pretty difficult because of all the memorization and understanding that has to go into it and make it even more challenging. The second hardest GMAT math concept is pretty related to the first, and it's probability. And part of the reason that probability is related to combinatorics is that a lot of probability problems actually rely on combinatorics in order to figure out totals and subtotals. So that makes these problems challenging in that they involve a challenging question type within them, but they also have other elements of complexity. So again, at least problems show up in probability. There are things like binomial probability, which has its own formula. Now, if you're curious specifically about at least problems on permutations, combinations, and probability, check out my video on the topic with a fun trick for how to handle them. The third hardest GMAT math concept is overlapping sets, which is a classic GMAT word problem type. And it comes in two flavors. So there is the matrix box overlapping set, which is commonly what we're going to use for two overlapping sets, but there's also the Venn diagram overlapping set, which can be used for two overlapping sets, but I more frequently use it for three overlapping sets. Now, these are tricky enough on their own because the best way of handling them is with one of these types of diagrams, so we have to be familiar with how to use them effectively and the common traps that come with labeling them incorrectly and filling in information in the wrong place. But they can be even more complex when we do things like bringing in real numbers mixed with things like percents or ratios or variables. So the fourth hardest GMAT math problem type is work rate, and this is another classic word problem type on the GMAT. It is a subset of the larger category of rate problems. Now, work rate problems have their own formula, which make things a little bit more challenging because, once again, there is some memorization involved here and some familiarity that we need going into these problems. But once again, they can be made even more complex. So applying that formula in multiple ways to account for things like starts and stops in a scenario-driven word problem. Now, if you struggle with word problems like overlapping sets and work rate, let me know in the comments if you'd like a video breaking down those particular word problem types, along with some of my other favorite word problems. The fifth hardest GMAT math problem concept is statistics. Now, not all statistics questions are particularly challenging. A lot of the statistical definitions are things that people are comfortable with and familiar with. However, there are some that are less familiar, like standard deviation. And there are applications of even the easier statistics or more familiar statistics that can be challenging for a lot of test takers. So a lot of test takers don't know how to handle things like weighted average or dealing with sets with consecutive integers or, again, scenario-driven word problems like min-max problems. So again, these can be challenging because test takers lack familiarity with the different applications. And the sixth hardest GMAT math problem concept is integer properties. Now, this is surprising for a lot of test takers because this is an arithmetic concept. It's addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and that seems like it should be easy enough to execute on. However, most of these problems are going to be more conceptual. They're not going to be about executing on these operations. They're going to be about understanding these operations. So there'll be things like definitions around factoring and divisibility and remainders, et cetera, et cetera. And the problems will often deal with numbers that are too large to calculate. So things like exponents and factorials will force us, instead of actually doing the operations, to understand them and apply what we know about them. So these are challenging for a lot of test takers because they are surprising, and test takers go in unprepared for them because they don't know that they're going to be this challenging. And those are six of the hardest GMAT math concepts. Now, there are definitely more, but these are some of the most inaccessible to test takers because of how hard they are to guess on without a solid foundation and understanding of the content. Now, these are all likely to come up at least once on your test day, so be sure to incorporate them into your study so you aren't stumped. Let us know if this video helped you by liking and subscribe for more videos from me and the other experts here at Magoosh. And if you have any questions or comments or suggestions for future videos, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.